Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the concept of DVB. That is nothing but a digital video broadcasting. Okay, so here we are trying to broadcast the video. Okay, so digital video broadcasting was mainly introduced for digital TVs. So basically the TV, in TV, we'll be getting video plus audio, right? Here we combinedly use DAB plus DVB, guys. Okay, so DVB is a digital radio standard for broadcasting digital video services. So it is similar to the DAB, that is nothing but the audio service, but it just transmits a video. That is the main thing here. Okay, so here we are having multiple satellites, guys. So digital television is based on DVB, S, C, H and T. So basically S represents a satellite. So with the help of satellites, you can send it. With the help of a direct cable connection, you can send it. So with the help of handheld devices like antennas and all those things, you can send it. Similarly, terrestrial, by using radio waves or some other waves also, you can send it. Okay, so in all the ways, you can send it, guys. So in Asia, we'll be normally using the handhelds, guys. Okay, standards. So the frequency are the same, guys. That is nothing but VHF and UHF. So the same frequencies which we discussed in the last lecture, the same. 130 to 260 megahertz, 430 to 882 megahertz. Okay, so it works using OFDM. I told you in the last lecture also, I'll be discussing about OFDM in this lecture. Yes, once we are done with the basic concept of DVB, we'll be discussing about this OFDM, guys. So don't worry. And the data rate is up to 5 Mbps to 30 Mbps data speed. You can send the video. Hence, you can send a good quality of video, guys. Okay? Yes. So now, what are the things that DVB supports? So basically, you can have a single channel, multi-channel and multiple channels. Okay? Yes. Okay. So basically, assume that there are 2 users or 100 users. So basically, initially, we will be having the audio services, multiple channels. So basically, whenever you are connecting to a Tata Sky or any kind of dish service, you will not be signing up for a single channel, right? So you don't want only MaTV or TV9 or any kind of news channel. You want some group of channels. So basically, all these service providers will provide this information to our company which we are using, like Tata Sky or any kind of service which we are using. So they will be converting these signals into OFDM signals. Okay, so that is nothing but orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. Okay, so once this is done, using the terrestrial one, these are passed into the internet and these are passed to the service providers. So these service providers, satellites you can say, or any kind of device like Tata Sky, they'll be providing it to the users. So this is the simple flow, guys. Got it? Yes. So you can write it in your own words, right? So basically initially we'll be having this, and from this we'll be converting it into OFDM, orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. Using internet, we'll be using the terrestrial networks, we'll be transmitting it to the service provider. So once it is received to the service provider, they'll be giving it to its users. So whoever are subscribed for those channels, they'll be getting the channels in that way. Got it? Yes. So I was making you wait from last lecture about OFDM, right? Yes. So now let us go through OFDM, guys. I think it could be better if I have gone it in the first, but I forgot it. So that is the reason why let us go it now itself. Okay? Yes. So OFDM, that is nothing but orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. So from here you can say that, okay, so we already know frequency division multiplexing. So what is new here? So you know frequency division multiplexing, which is looks like this, right? So basically, with respect to frequency, these things will divide. So basically, if it is frequency and if it is a time, so in this way you used to divide it, right? So this is 99.5 FM is for this guy, 99.7 is for this guy, and 1900 is for this guy. And you will be having some guard bands, right? So to avoid any kind of collisions of data or noises of data, right? Yes. So this, if you update something, so you will be getting this orthogonal frequency division multiplexing. Okay. So it is simple, similar to frequency division multiplexing with a huge change. In frequency division multiplexing, we divide the frequency band into non-overlapping signals, even we add some guard bands or gaps, you can say. Okay, so in OFDM, all of these stations are brought together, guys, in such a way that there is no overlapping of them. So basically, there is no overlapping or mixing of signals. So that is the main thing here. So in OFDM, all the sub-channels are closely packed, making sure that they are orthogonal. So basically, orthogonal, in simple words, you can say they are perpendicular. So when one is high, the other will be low. When one is high, the other will be low. So in that format, you'll be using it. Okay. So orthogonal to each other and no guard band between them. So the image of these three will look like this, guys. So if you observe here,
the signal 1, 2, 3, the signal 1 is a max at this point, but rest signal 2 and 3 are minimum here. Similarly, when the signal 2 is high, signal 1 and 3 are minimum. When signal 3 is high, signal 2 is minimum. So it should be below it, guys. So as per my drawing issues, I have just drawn it in a wrong way. Okay. Yes. So in this way, by using the concept of orthogonality, we'll be solving this problem. Okay. Yes. So orthogonal here means when a substation has a maximum, then rest all have zero energy. Okay. Hence, we can say that one is not interfering other, and the receiver will be doing the same logic. Like it will be separating. Who is having that? Based on that, it will be separating the signals. Okay. So this concept is orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, and this is mainly used in our televisions and our audio broadcasting and video broadcasting. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got some basic idea about this broadcasting systems. Guys, I'm 100% sure there is a high chance that we could get a direct question from broadcasting system. So please be perfect with them, guys, and practice the diagrams also. Okay. Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea on this. So in the next lecture, we'll be going through the review of the second unit, like what are the important topics and all those things. After that, we'll be starting the third unit, guys. Okay. Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.